Kate's Crafts. I have another wedding album to share with you guys today. And I finished it just in time. I just ran out of my glue. So, crisis averted, the album is finished, but I do need to buy more glue now to move on to the next thing. But this is using the Heartfelt Creations Classic Wedding Collection, and I'll try and remember to put all the product item numbers down in the description box below. That way, if you guys can't just find it with a quick search, you should be able to, but if you can't, I'll put the numbers down below, especially the dyes that I used. So just scroll down for that. So on the cover, I did a couple little flower collages with the mini blooms collection from Michaels. They just come in a little box like this. Oh, I don't have the sticker on the back, but there's not many flowers in them. So I used a couple different collections. One had red and white, one was pink and pink, then one was peach and pink, and with these ones that have like just a little bit of color in them, and there was another one with pastels. And anyways, I just threw a bunch of clusters together. I have a little charm here. It says handmade with love. And this little white ribbon I did get from Michaels. I used the whole spool. There wasn't really a whole lot on it. This ribbon, I cannot remember where I got it from. The closure is a hook and eyes closure. I don't have the entire packaging because I threw it out, but it just comes with three, and these are the silver, just the silver ones. These pearls, actually, I got in a huge spool like this, and I just cut them apart, and I found these at the dollar store. I found them at Dollarama in the wedding section, so I couldn't not get them. But if you're looking for them, that's where they are. This is bling, is the Dries Bling on a Roll. If you see anything shimmery and sparkly, it's either a combination of or standalone of diamond stickles, glossy accents, I know that too, and Wink of Stella in clear. So if anything shimmers or sparkles and catches your eye, that is what it's covering, and I did that on almost every page. I think actually the last two pages I need to go back and put on my Wink of Stella and my diamond stickles, just because I really wanted to get this video done. And it's taken me quite a while to finish this book. Anyways, this love is just one of the cutouts. You can buy them at Michaels. I think it was 3 in a pack, so you've seen me use it before. So I'll just go around the side here. I do have the last name covered up just because I know by the time this video gets up, the bride and groom will have the album. But just in case, if I happen to put this up on YouTube beforehand and I accidentally forget to set my blog post and Facebook post as timed, and it goes up today versus after they receive this, then I don't want them to know it's theirs. So Tim Holtz ornate plate. I just took one of the little images of the bride and groom, glued it back behind, covered it with glossy accents. Glossy accents is a little older, so with the amount that I put on here, it didn't go quite as clear as I thought it would, but it did give it a nice vintage antique-y look, which I actually really like. Same with my label down here. And this is, I forgot to get my little box out, the Spellbinders Timeless Rectangle, and I just used the smallest one. And I just stamped the couple's last name with Established 2017. The ink around the outside is Tim Holtz Tattered Rose Distress Ink. Again, diamond stickles, glossy accents. Just leave it on the side. And on the back, more of those pearls, more of this ribbon as closure, obviously. And one of the little postage stamps just with my signature on it and the date. So when I date my albums, I just put the month and the year. I don't put the day. I just don't. I don't know why. I've never really thought about it. I just haven't the days on them. But anyways, there's 7 pages in this album. Oh, I forgot to say the spine is, or not the spine, the cover is 8x8 with a 4-inch spine. Pages are 7.5x7.5 square. So on the inside front cover, I did one of the little flip books that I've been doing in the wedding albums. So these are 4x6. You won't have to trim down a picture to put it in. Just glue it down. I do have a little pocket here with one of the little cutter parts. And in the back, I did take one of the trims, says on your wedding day, and made a little belly band with a few little cutter parts as well. And a pocket. The bling trim is the Doris Bling on a Roll. That didn't get glued down quite as well as I thought. I'll have to go back and touch that up. Some more little flowers. These are just some of the border strips. And this die, I'll tell you guys right now, this one is the Regal Borders and Pockets by Heartfelt Creations. I also use the Classic Border Basics and the Delicate Border Basics throughout the album. So I'll put these numbers down in the description bar, and you'll see those throughout the album. So on the opposite page, I did one of the dies, made a pocket, nice big pocket there. More bling on a roll, more bling around the inside, more of the pearls. Going to the second layout here, I did a pocket with one of the cutter parts and just put a few tags on the top. A few flowers, more bling, went kind of crazy with the bling. Another one of the dies, and as we open this, another big generous pocket. Actually, this one's quite deep. I only have a few tags in there, but the bride can certainly load it up. Nice little tuck spot here with one of the cutter parts. A few more flowers up here. Border strip. I need to add Wink of Stella to those flowers. I'll just touch everything up once I'm done. And I did some fussy cutting here. I don't like fussy cutting, but I thought it would be super cute to have the bells with the rose vines holding in a few tags. So that's what I did. So they don't all have to be in behind, but I did leave the base page blank so the bride can add nice big photos. 5x7 would be wonderful. She can cascade a couple of 4x6s. And just a little waterfall here with a hidden hinge. And this is a magnetic closure. I did use the basic gray small magnets. Just an unopened pack that I have. I find the small ones are really sturdy on their own, so I didn't feel the need to use the large ones in this album. I just have 2 identical deep pockets. I only have a total of 5 mats in here, but I could go back and load up more just where I have a couple extra pages of the cardstock that is not cut into at all. But they'll probably have to be backed with cardstock. I did a few little tuck spots here with a few more little journaling tags. Certainly a small photo can be placed on the back with journaling on the front. But I thought they looked cute. A couple of bows with some more flowers, some more, I was going to say bling, but these are pearls. So on this brand, this is magnetized and it flips down just with a few cut aparts. And just a nice big spot for a photo here. Switch this up so you can see the bottom. And just glossy accents, diamond stickles, a little Wink of Stella in there, some more bling on a roll. And same with the front. And this flower is actually cut out and popped up as well. I did a similar thing on this side with the cut aparts, and this flips up with the bells at the top. And just one of the tags, I put a few of the cut aparts in there. So photos, journaling. Geez, even if she wants, she can lay some of these out at the wedding and have guests put little memories on them if she wants. If I happen to get this to the bride and groom before the wedding, that would be a good idea. 2 nice big 4x6 photo mats with some flowers, and I made a few little bows and some of the cut aparts just coated with glossy accents and some pearls in the corner. And these are little stoppers. You can probably see I have a couple of cut aparts tucked in here on either side. So So lots of room for more photos. This one, this gray one's getting lost back there. So I'm just gonna move it around so it seems a little easier. So on this page, I did another waterfall, but it's cascading sideways. So all the pages are staggered, and this one is magnetized to this to the other one with the bow, just to hold it all in place. So this one flips down, these flip up. There's no pockets on these. I did add a few border strips, but that's about it. So here, bows come undone. I'll retie them nice and pretty for the bride and groom, and these just flip over. I'm not going to tie them up right now. I'll tie them later. So here I have two identical pages, double pocket. I'll just take one side out to show you guys. Some ribbon, some bling on a roll, lots of pockets. And these photo mats are 4.25 by 6.25. I haven't backed them. I thought the backs looked fine without too much of different patterns on the back. So same with these. They're not backed with the cardstock. I used 110-pound cardstock, so it would have been really bulky if I had backed them. That is, it's chunky as it is. So again, more glossy accent, no glossy accents, actually just Wink of Stella and Diamond Stickles. So these are the last two pages. I have a tag here, and you can do a little tuck spot back in there. I don't have, I might have another couple of tiny tags that are small enough just to tuck in behind there. So I might add a couple. So this is just a double pocket. Could add a lot more photo mats. I can fit my hand down in there mostly. I just don't want to curl up the die here. So like I said, just photo mats. These are just the cut aparts. So unfortunately I didn't measure them. Silly me. But I just slip those in there. So on this page, it is quite a large page. So just I made some fold overs with the photo mats that came in the paper collection, so they just flip out. I did add, I hope you can see that, a little corner pocket here. It's not tight, that's why these slid out. I may add a few more photo mats just to make it a little tighter, but there is a little postage stamp from the paper collection, a nice thick pocket. And I actually did a little book here. And it's all connected with ribbon, so there's no hinges. And fold over, lots of space for journaling photo mats. I guess if the bride wanted, she could just wrap it all around and tie it that way. That up in a nice bowl before they get it. And then this flips out, and I just put a little two tiny pieces of ribbon, and these are 5.25 by 7.25 photo mats. So 5x7s, front and back. I didn't put paper on the back, just like I said, cardstock is 110-pound weight, so it's kind of stiff and flimsy as it is. Why I had a little bit of a hard time getting these out from under the ribbon. And I just left this blank, just that way the bride and groom can add a nice picture, or they can leave it if they want. That's up to them. They could maybe put some cards that guests have given them in here, or little bits and pieces from the wedding, little tiny decorations can go in here. But I hope you guys enjoyed, And like I said, I'll put the the product numbers down below to everything I used. I'll try to remember to do that. Anyways, if you like the album, give me a thumbs up. You can subscribe, you can follow me on here on YouTube. Also, I have a Facebook page and blog and Instagram. So I try and put out little teasers on Instagram and Facebook every now and again, as well as my blog. But if you guys have any questions, just leave a comment, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.